What happens if you take a weevil and drop another weevil on top of it? Okay, I'm kind of hoping for a bit more damage on that one. Well, the answer is this. This is the weevil custom that's just come out for GTA Online. It takes the original weevil and they flattened him down and turned him into a hot rod. Yeah, this is going to be good. So on the rear, we have instantly got the world's tiniest little wing. Look at how small he is. Okay, yep, that's a spoiler. That's a big spoiler. It's now turned into a shopping trolley. I kind of want to see where this goes. Front bumpers, it'd be nice to probably have some. I guess the off-road vibe is what we're going for here rather than a hot rod. Considering the big massive spoiler, I kind of want to go for like a drag race style one. Then on our rear bumpers, we have another bunch of options. I guess this is basically just turning it into a Baja bug. Yeah, that's not really what I want to do for the first build, but we're going to be doing multiple builds, so we'll probably use that at some point in the video. We have some running boards and an off-road kit. I mean, I'm definitely going to make a call off-road in a minute. We have lots of exhaust options. Always good to see. The quad stingers. They're cool. The mecha zoomies. We have this. That's kind of weird because actually the texture quality of that is not as good as the rest of the car. Ooh, red deflectors. Colored deflectors. These are cool. Hood spikes. Hood chains. Okay, I think I know what builds we're going to be doing. We then have some options for the bonnets. What? I don't think I've ever seen a Beetle hot rod that ended up with grills like that, but I kind of dig it. Yeah, actually, I'm not sure what the grill would be used for because the engine's in the back. We have more stuff on the bonnet as well. We have some badge options here. Skull ornaments, diamond ornaments. These are really, I mean, I get it, they're for the hot rod stuff. We've got all of this stuff for the roof, including a bunch of different colored surfboards. Just so you can, I don't know, color match your car to them. I'm actually going to go with the tire rack one because then it looks like that it's like a car that you've actually just driven to the track and you've taken your tires with you. So I'm actually going to keep that in. Suspension has many options. If you thought that was low already, woo boy. Yeah, for this one, I'll probably jack it down a little bit, but we don't need to go crazy. World War II bomber seats? Basic bucket seats? Oh, these are cool. Why do we get these options in regular cars? I know they don't really fit, but that's the fun of customization. I kind of wish we had these in the other cars. Barrel seats? Oh yeah, they're safe. To be fair, if we were in an accident in a car like this, it would just turn to tin and you would turn into beans. You'd turn into a baked bean tin. We have some stuff for the lights as well. We have guards. We have it moved to the front. Oh, okay. We have little tiny ones. Oh, they are cool in red. I have got some ideas for builds. Oh boy. I love this. This is probably the coolest car I've seen in a while. I know I like the 80s cars and the Japanese cars, but these ones just have more fun parts on them. This is really like taking inspiration from the Volkswagen Accord scene for sure. Then we have the same treatment on the back, I guess. Just a bunch of different covers for these brake lights. Also got some nice bullet shaped ones as well. We also have some different mirrors as well. Then we have some livery options. Of course the flames. We've got some backyard camo. We've got some racing ones. We've got some, oh man. Oh, there are some cool things in here. As this is going to be a drag car, I guess I'm going to go with the Evil Weevil, as I like that sort of like old school drag car thing where they always used to have like a custom name on the side with graphics and stuff. So I think that matches that quite well. On the wheels, they're kind of a bit odd. As soon as I change these wheels, these things are just way too big. They're massive. Look at the size of them. I think the only way to keep the giant chunky tires on this one is to keep the standard wheels. So I've gone for red on the secondary color because then I want it to match up with the livery here. And then I've just gone for probably like a dark black or something like that. Well, actually, that black steel works nice. And there is our drag racer build done. Doesn't really suit the drag car thing that I ended up going with. So I'm just going to throw away this build and let's just move on to the next one because the next two ideas I have, I think, are going to be banging. So let's find out. Let's see how right I am. Well, here it is. This is the second build. I wanted to go for a full off-road style build. I've gone for full max dirt. I've gone for a lighter matte cream and then a matte olive drab, just so we have a nice different color between them. And then I have a camo over the top. I've gone for yellow headlights. I've gone for the mesh grill. because I kind of wanted to use it somewhere and I knew it wasn't going to fit into the next build. And I think it works. I like it. I've gone for the tools on the bonnet. I've gone for the more rugged wing mirrors. I've gone for the vintage sun visor as I just think it looks cool. I've gone for all the stuff on the roof, including the stepladder down and all the extra fuel. Then on the rear, I've just gone for these crazy big exhausts. Remove the rear bumper because I've gone for this Baja thing at the back. And I've gone for these cool scooped Beetle lights on the rear. And I've gone for big chunky off-road steel wheels to finish the look. And I think this looks absolutely awesome. I think this needs to go somewhere a bit more suitable. So with the power of editing, we are now here in the quarry. And oh, this just fits right in. Isn't that a picture? That is a picture. Look at this. What a scene this is. I have gone for standard height suspension. Maybe that's affecting my handling a little bit. But I didn't want it to be really low to the ground. I wanted it to be higher up. Yeah, I am very, very happy with this build. Is that dude in the tractor really going on the highway? Well, good luck everyone behind. I guess it's a quiet day. Well, I did say there'd be three builds. So I guess we have to move on to the next one. Okay, here it is, and I'd probably say this is not the best setting for this, so I'm gonna go to the perfect setting in just a moment, but I just wanted to compare the two that we have, and I really liked this one, but I really like this one. There is something really cool about this. I wanted to go for matte black. I was gonna go for the rusty livery, then decided it's a bit too played. I wanted to go for black and red. I went for the spikes on the roof as I thought that was really cool. I've gone for the metal bomber seats. On the rear, I've gone for these big massive exhausts, of course. I've gone for the bullet style rear lights. I've gone for the red style front lights and red underglow. And I've gone for these black steel wheels right here. Also, I went for the chain as we've never seen a chain as a mod before, and it just looks really raw and cool. I love it. And then I matched it up with the chrome retro grill, and it just works so nice together. Let me put this in its actual home and we can see it properly. And here we are in Halloween time. I mean, it's Halloween, so why not? I've gone full Halloween. It is nighttime. We've got some awful, oh, look at this. Awfully green looking sky. We've got thunder, we've got rain, we've got the puddles on the ground. I've gone for red xenon lights as well, just to really bring home the red. Oh, this thing just looks right at home, doesn't it? This is brilliant. Amazingly timed for Halloween. This build is just the perfect Halloween car, I think. I think Rockstar have done a good job with this one. I will say it. This is pretty good. Well, there we go, guys. Let me know in the comments which one you think is best. And then tell me why it's this one. Because it's clearly this one. Why would you vote for anything else? There we go, guys. That is it. What an amazing car this is. I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.